Minnesota, south of country. I'm going deer hunting. Welcome to another episode of Salty Country. I'm going deer hunting without a gun. Yep, you heard it right. Going deer hunting without a gun. Stick around. All right, I've got to my location. We're going to see if any of them walk in on us. It's a little windy, and it's been raining for 3 days, so they can ease in on you. You won't even realize it, so you got to keep a lookout. actually on explaining what I'm doing. I currently don't deer hunt anymore. I enjoyed it when I did it. We have a fair amount of deer here on the farm. And I just enjoy getting out in the woods sometimes. So I'm down here just, I know that they travel through this part of the property a good bit. It's got a lot of cover. So I'm just down here listening to nature and see if I happen to catch a glimpse of them today. With it being windy like it is, they may be bedded down, not moving right now. But the reason that I don't deer hunt is because I have means for providing food for my family right now. If it comes to the point where I do need food, I know where to get it. I'm not down here sitting at a food plot or anything like that. I'm in their environment 100%. If you hunt on a food plot or where you have food plots, in my opinion, you're a cheater. To me, it takes the thrill of the hunt out of it. If, in a sense, you're just baiting the deer. So, to me, that's an unfair advantage. But I want to reiterate, this is a free country. You can do what you want to do. Especially hunting within the bounds of the law. If they allow it, and that's what you want to do, go for it. But I'm just saying, for me, I would feel like I was a cheater if I was sitting out here next to a food plot where deer had been coming in to feed constantly. I'm going to walk around for a little bit, see if I see any rubs down here. If they're bedded down, I may end up jumping them. This is about 30 feet from where I was sitting. Pretty good sized deer. walk over here and see if they've been down, get them a drink of water. Looks like they've been down through here. Some of the leaves are pushed down, but so many leaves have fallen the last few days. Can't really tell other than just where they've stepped, pushed the leaves in. This is where they like to come a lot, in the bottoms to get them a drink of water. I have seen them moving down the creek bed. I'm going to ease on around the bottom and see if I can see them. They like this area right here too. A lot of oaks up on that hill. Acorns, and they come down here into the bottoms. Also, see if I can see any fresh rubs. There was one right back there. Let's take a look at it. Ever so slightly, they've scraped that tree right there. Cows are out there checking me out. Making sure I'm not a predator. I rode back up here to the burn pile. This thing's still smoking after 3 days of rain. I'm just going to check around it, see if the deer had been down here since it rained yesterday and last night. Don't see anything so far. Sometimes I look out the bathroom window in the morning and there's deer down here. So they just probably haven't been in the area here in the last day or two. I'm sure I'm going to ruffle some feathers with that food plot cheater's comment. But anyway, that's just how I feel. I don't, you know, if you want to hunt where there's food plots and all that kind of stuff, it's 100% up to you. I was more so just expressing my personal opinion about myself. I just don't feel that it's something I could do. All right, I made it back up to the house. That's going to be all for this episode. Remember, if you like our content, subscribe, share it with your friends. We'll see you on the next one.